Assalamu alaikum, welcome to another tutorial of Yugitections. Today we will learn about how to create navigation drawers in Android. So what is navigation drawer? This is a simple view of navigation drawer. When we click this window, it will show some items here, and when we click any of the item here, it will open a fragment, right? So the group of fragments are stored here in a navigation drawer. And whenever we want to call it from any fragment, we have to just click here, right? So it's a built-in class of an Android, and we have to implement this activity and show you how to create and how to use it. So before starting our tutorial, if you are not a subscriber of this channel, please subscribe this channel. Also like our Facebook page, which is Yugitections Tutorials. So let's begin. So we create here a new Android activity. We select it and then we name it as whatever you want to name this. I am giving the name of the activity, navigate activity. Then just finish it and wait till it build the classes, right? So in this project I have only one class, but after this navigation drawer, because it's a built-in class of an Android, so it create this package. And in this UI package, these are three more packages which named as gallery, home, and show slideshow, right? After this, let me show you layout. In layout, activity navigate is an UI of activity navigate, right? Then the content main, fragment, gallery fragment, home fragment, and slideshow fragment. And this is the main header of a navigation drawer. We can change the text over here because it's an XML, and we can change whatever we want here, the image or logo of your application, the text and title or the description, right? Then what is next? Let me show you. This is the navigation, mobile navigation XML, in which we define the fragments. The purpose to create this tutorial, just want to show you how to create mobile navigation and how to use these fragments using an XML, right? So let me show you a code of this fragment. This is the navigation tag in the XML, and we just give the ID to the navigation. Then we add here the destination from which the application start, right? Start destination. And these are the fragments on which when we click any of the item, it will show these fragments. So where these fragments stored, this is the package name where the fragment is stored. This means that Yugitection, then UI, then gallery, and then gallery fragment, right? This is the fragment that is called here, right? This is the label. You want to change the label, you can write here in the string, right? So let me show you. If I want to create another item, what I will do here, I will just add here a fragment, and then I will give the name to it, demo, right? Then we will create here a package name, and here demo fragment. Then we will just create here a new Java class, demo fragment, extend here fragment. And then what is the next? Create here a layout of this fragment. So now let me create here a view model class of this fragment, right? Extend this with view model, right? So I will use here a variable which will be private, mutable, live data. Let's give a data type to it, and the text is, and then mutable live data is of string type. And let me just add here the variable name, Now what is the next process? I will just add here public demo view model, right? And in which we will just initialize this mText equals to new mutable live data and mutable live data dot set value, and the value is this is demo fragment, that's it. And just call this method or variable, this is a public method, so we have to give the return type live data, which is of a string type, right? And get text, so we will just return live data, which is mutable live data. So we will just give this variable, and that's it, right? We created here a view model of a demo fragment, and now we have to just add here a view variable. This is variable, and now we will just implement this method on create view, return view. View equals to inflator.inflate or dot layout fragment demo, and then we add here the container, and the root is false, right? And now we will just add here or initialize here our demo view model. So we will just give here view model equals to new view model provider, and provide here this and dot get class. So we just call our class, which is demo model dot class, right? So we initialize our view model here, and now we just init our resources first. Source, and our resources is just a text view which we have created in this XML. So let me just add here text view, text view equals to text view, view dot find view by id, r dot id dot, so the id of our class will be demo, text demo, because we just copied this, that is why I am text demo, right? And now what we have to do here, we will just use our view model and get the text dot observable, and we will just say get own lifecycle and new, and that's it. So this is the text. When we get here the text, whatever the text change in this body, it will return here. So just mText dot set text. Whatever text is written in this string, it will write here. So we have created our demo class, and we have to just initialize it in this navigation menu, right? Which is here. So just remove this and add here demo fragment, right? And we have to give here our string, which is menu equals menu demo. Right, and again we just switch to this XML and change the demo string, right? And now we will just give the fragment demo here, which is the UI of our fragment. And one more thing which we have to consider, whatever we ID we have created on this mobile navigation, we have to mention it on the activity main drawer, right? So let's split it and add here the ID, right? So what we have created nav demo, right? And I don't have any icon, so I'm using this icon, right? And then we will just use menu demo, right? So we have created here another item, right? And let me show you, the segment is now called somewhere, right? So when we click here, it will jump to this XML, right? So after this, we have to just add here navigation item, right? So we just add here the ID r.id.demo. So after this, we have to go to the manifest activity, and now we will call the navigation activity as a launcher activity, right? And give here the theme that is created over here. And after play, I will show you if we want to create a button on this activity which we have created here, demo activity, how we will call the fragment. So let me create a button over here. Right, match parent and rep content. Top to bottom off, right? And the ID will be text demo, and then we will just say start to start off parent and end to end of parent. Then we will just add here the text, which is child. Why I write here child fragment? Because I am calling the fragment from now, this fragment, right? So after this, let me show you that the item is added over here as demo, right? After clicking it, it will just set the text, this is a demo fragment, right? And on the top it will shows demo, right? So we created here a fragment in the navigation drawer, right, which is demo. And now what we have do, what we will do here, we will just call the child fragment from this fragment, right? So let me add the ID, and ID will be copy this fragment and just paste it and name it as demo child, right? Refactor, and after splitting, just change the name of this fragment and remove this one, right? All right. And let me just copy the view model of this and also paste here demo child view model, right? And just say demo child. So we will do here same, initialize here the view. So let's check the text is this, right? We created this fragment, but we didn't call this fragment anywhere, right? So what we will do, we will just go to the mobile navigation, right? And then just simply call another fragment, and we will not mention it on any of the XML, right, which is on menu. Demo child, right? And we will just give here demo child, right? This is the menu. We will give this text, just initialize the text, which is not in menu but it's a string, right? So we will just say demo. Demo child, and here demo child fragment, right? So then we just add here the fragment layout, which is demo child fragment layout, and in this fragment we have to call the action. The action will perform when the action will perform, it will call this fragment, right? So we just add here action, and action ID will be navigation demo child, right? And the name or the destination will be right or you can also change this thing. You can remove this or just give it the ID, whatever you want to say. Let me just add here this navigation fragment, right? And this is the destination of this fragment, right? And this is the ID where we call this action, right? So what is the next step? We have to just add here. So we have created here a button which is child fragment. So let's just call the ID. Child BTN. Let me just call this button. And then we will just add here. This is the code we have to focus on. We will just add here the navigation controller, right? Just add here nav control equals to navigation. Navigation. Dot find controller. So we have to just add here the ID r.id.navhost, right? Navhost fragment. This is the navhost fragment, and have to add here the get activity from which it's get the view, right? And then we will add here if get activity is not equals to null, then just called it and initialize it. After initializing this, we have to add here nav control dot navigate and just pass the ID r dot ID dot the action name, right? So what is the action name? I remember child fragment. This is the action. So this is the action ID. So we have to give the action ID to it. After giving the action ID, let's just run it and see what it will do. So let's run it and see what are the results. So here is a mistake. So let me just add this ID. Here. And now rerun it. So let's see what it will display. We will click here the demo, and now we will click this child fragment button, and this says this is child fragment demo, right? So what we have done, we have just performed an action on this mobile navigation, right? And open a fragment which is shown as this is demo child fragment. So it doesn't show the title of our fragment. So let me show you. This is the menu which we have called. We have to call here demo child, right? So let's rerun it and we'll see the change. It will just display the current name of the fragment, right? So let me show you. So now let's again click demo child fragment, and it shows this is child demo fragment. This is demo child fragment. So hope you will like this video. If you like this video, please give thumbs up to this video. Also like our Facebook page, which is UK Techtions Tutorial. Also follow us on Instagram. If you want me to make any tutorial, just leave a comment section of any video and I will reply back soon and create that video. Stay blessed, stay happy and stay healthy. Stay connected with my channel, which is UK Techtions Tutorial. We will make more interesting tutorial. Inshallah, Allah Hafiz.